So let's talk about diabetes and the other types of diabetes mellitus. Hello everyone, I am Dr. Maria Concepcion Gungon, or Doc Apple for short. I'm a practicing internist and endocrinologist at Sacred Heart Hospital of Malolos, Incorporated. So my grandmother was a patient with type 2 diabetes, and I've seen her wins and losses against the disease. Growing up, I saw her inject insulin religiously. And early on, I had that curiosity about the diabetes itself. And as endocrinologists, we are experts in treating diabetes mellitus as well as thyroid disorders. Also, we specialize in diagnosing and treating health conditions related to metabolic disorders as well as hormonal imbalances. So, diabetes mellitus is a chronic, lifelong disease that affects how the body uses insulin and glucose. So, it is characterized by abnormal elevations in the blood sugar in the body, leading to multiple organ complications. First, we have prediabetes. Prediabetes means you have a higher than normal blood sugar level. It's not enough to be considered type 2 diabetes yet, but without lifestyle changes such as diet, exercise, as well as medical treatment, adults and children with prediabetes are at high risk to develop type 2 diabetes mellitus. A fasting blood sugar of 100 to 125 milligrams per deciliter, a 2-hour 75 grams OGTT result of more than 140 to 199 milligrams per deciliter, and a random blood sugar of more than 140 to 199 milligrams per deciliter are considered pre-diabetes. So, type 1 diabetes mellitus is a form of diabetes in which not enough insulin is being produced by the body. So the lack of insulin results in high blood sugar levels, and the main treatment for patients with type 1 diabetes is insulin. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. It is the most common form of diabetes. It is characterized by high blood sugar, insulin resistance, and a relative lack of insulin. We proceed with gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes is diabetes diagnosed for the first time during pregnancy. Like other types of diabetes, it affects how your body utilizes sugar. So gestational diabetes causes high blood sugar that can affect your pregnancy as well as the baby. So what are the symptoms of diabetes mellitus? Some people with diabetes may not have symptoms at all. However, in certain instances, when the sugar is extremely high, patient may experience, number one, frequent urination. They would also experience excessive thirst, uhaw na uhaw. Increased hunger, laging gutom, mga namamaya, there's weight loss. Tiredness, poor concentration, numbness or namamanhid yung mga kasukasuan, yung mga kamay, paa, blurring of vision, frequent infection, as well as low wound healing are just some of the symptoms of your type 2 diabetes mellitus. So depending on what type of diabetes you have, blood sugar monitoring, insulin, oral drugs may be part of your treatment. And take note, eating a healthy diet, staying at a healthy weight, and getting regular physical activity are also important parts of managing your diabetes. So behind this white coat, I am a runner. So in my free time, I do run. So every weekends, I do spend my weekends with my friends and family doing some running. Again, I am Doc Apple Gungon. I am a doctor, I'm a runner, and have a good sweet day.
Sacred Heart Hospital of Malolos, 55 taong serbisyong subok at kalingang maaasahan.